It's Tuesday, June 28th already, 2016. And as far as I know, no musicians have died of note lately. Hopefully that all business is done. And just sitting here. Daily Nerd was late today because I had to actually work today on a website. And make a buck. Well, like Tuesdays, we're going to do a theme of movies. Because as we all know, movies come out on Tuesdays. The new releases. Hey there, Thomas. Welcome to the Daily Nerdler, episode 14. Movies. We're going to talk about Batman versus Superman because it just came out today. Greetings, fellow Nerdler. Woo! So I'm shooting today from my bedroom. So just fired up the... Oh, you saw that, did ya? Well, it'll be up there for a while unless I get told to take it down. It's a long one, and I'm pretty much in it from the first 45 minutes, then a break for about, I don't know, half hour or so, and then I come back in. And so if you're really watching it, hear me play, well, now you know where to look for it. Otherwise, you can listen to the whole thing and enjoy the whole evening of music. It's just great to have going on in the background. Ah, yeah, thank you. We had a lot of fun last night. But, yeah, we're talking about Batman versus Superman today. Have you seen it? Did you see it in the theaters, Thomas? Did you see that movie? Where's the best angle here? Didn't see it, huh? Well, the wife and I went and saw it when it came out because we wanted to see it. We knew it was probably going to be bad. But for a date night, we went and seen it. That's how I treat my wife. If you haven't seen it, I'm not going to spoil it. But if you don't want to hear somebody talk about how good or bad it is, this is probably not the video for you to hang out with. If you don't care, stay in. But, yeah, Batman versus Superman. I think the premise from the get-go of Batman fighting Superman because he was angry about how the way Superman is an alien with all these powers and can't be trusted and can just do pretty much anything he wants. I think they set up Ben Affleck's character as Batman. Yeah. Well, it's because of the basic premise. Is that Ben Affleck's character was a little angry twat. I mean, it's like, how old is this guy? And they set him up to be like an angry teenager, mad at the world. And didn't really give Superman any kind of due justice. You know, or consideration, is that, well, he's not human, and he's not suspect to human foibles or predilections to abuse power. Although General Zod is, Kal-El isn't. Memphis, Tennessee, checking in. Welcome, Wayne, and welcome the rest of you that are showing up. We got 5 viewers today talking about Batman versus Superman. And that's the way it kind of ran throughout the whole movie. Is that we've got Ben Affleck, which is, I'll give him his credit, he was a decent Batman, except they had him treating his character as if he was an angry teenager. And then, you know, the whole thing about taking on Superman seriously, I don't care who you like better, Batman or Superman, seriously, Batman is a guy in a costume with really cool toys. And that's the other thing I had a problem with the movie, they gave Batman guns. They've been doing it slowly, ever more slowly. Every Batman movie that comes out, they give him more and more guns. It started out with guns on the Batmobile, one of Tim Burton's versions, and I really despise that. Batman despises guns because that's how his parents were killed. He uses everything but guns to bring people to justice. He doesn't kill people, just like Superman. That's why he was such a good, solid role model for so many, and that's why Batman still is in one of my top superheroes. But what they did to the Superman or Batman character in this movie was just, it was shameful. And then you spend most of the movie with Batman railing against this alien Superman and then fighting with him in an absolutely ugly piece of armored suit that was worse off than the Mark I Iron Man suit in the first Iron Man movie. I mean, it was terrible. Seriously, Batman, Bruce Wayne is a billionaire. He can afford a little nicer suit. So, even if it had to be a hunk of massive metal to combat Superman, it's like, no. It was sad. It was really sad. And then when they finally, almost near the end of the movie, where Batman finally comes to grips with the realization that Superman is a good guy and he is there to fight evil, they kind of leave Ben Affleck hanging out there in the wind in the scene where he comes to grips with this and apologizes to Superman. I mean, literally, they wrote him into a corner, and then they kind of like, it's almost like you could feel the cast, the crew turning away, and just to leave Ben Affleck standing there dressed as Batman in this awful armored suit to say, oh, gee, I'm sorry. I guess I didn't know what I was doing. It was pitiful. Sure, there were some great scenes, and there were some awesome scenes in this movie, and it is well worth watching. But as far as seeing it in the theater and wasting, you know, who knows how much money wherever you're living, it cost me $60 for two tickets and popcorn and soda for me and my wife to go see it. So I'm out $60. I will not be buying this movie. I probably will rent it again or wait until it comes out on HBO to watch it again. But just to pick it apart, spoilers. Yes, they show some of the enhanced humans, or what they're calling metahumans, which includes Flash. They show a very cryptic clip of what could be Flash from the Flash TV series. And then they also have, of course, a guest star of Diana Pryce as Wonder Woman. And boy, is she hot. Oh my goodness. It's almost worth the movie just to see her in the few scenes she's in at the end in the big battle. Yes, it is worth seeing Diana Pryce as Deanna Price as Wonder Woman. And then there is a very short glimpse of Aquaman. Yeah, you spent a buttload. And the one thing where me and my wife both disagreed is that the way they showed the clip of Aquaman, which is played by Jason Momoa, there was a scene where the spear that got the kryptonite on it is dropped down into some water, and it would have been easy to write that so Jason Momoa grabs it and brings it up and joins the fray, or just turns it over so they could kill the big evil monster that is what used to be Dead Zod is now Huge Monster Zod. So again, if you haven't seen it, these are spoilers and you've been warned. But yeah, they could have wrote the scene better. Otherwise, it was just a little bit of video clip of Jason Momoa's Aquaman in his suit underwater, and they could have done so much better. By the time we were halfway home, my wife and I had basically rewritten all the bad scenes. And in our honest opinion, it was a much better movie. And it would not have taken much. Just some different plot tweaks and some different scenes in the problem areas. And again, taking away the whole premise of Batman versus Superman. That was just basically an inflammatory title. Ever since its inception and ever since it came out in the comic books. An inflammatory title to sell comic books and to sell movie tickets because it's inflammatory. Oh, Batman versus Superman. Superman's going to kick his ass. Batman, oh, Batman's got all those toys. He can kick Superman's ass. And it's just, yeah, it's funny how a few issues. Seriously, a better movie was Batman and Superman. That would have sold just as many tickets. Batman and Superman, the Dawn of the Justice League. You know, this is a great way to bring this about and bring these two people together. These metahumans and Batman and Superman to create the Dawn of Justice or the Justice League of America. Yeah, it would have been great. And that way you could bring out Ben Affleck's actual acting talents, which he does have. But you don't have to make him walk through three-fourths of a movie whining and being angry like a spoiled teenager. That this alien is taking over, you know, it's like, oh, wow, you can be the only vigilante justice out there? No, why don't you say, wow, now I've got somebody who can help, who's got some powers, who can really do things, and then maybe, you know, be suspicious of his motives. He's an alien. Sure, I get that, but there's better ways of doing it the way they did it. But again, it's a fun movie. I thought it was a good movie with some bad parts. So all in all, on my Rotten Tomato meter. Oh, wait, somebody already has that. On my Nerdometer, I would give this movie a 5 out of 10. Watch it, yes, but don't spend a lot of money to watch it. And then be prepared to suffer through some very bad scenes. But that's going to be it for episode 14 of the Daily Nerdler. Yes, we've got 14 of these in the can. The Nerdometer, yes. And we are actually building a 3D Nerdometer, or Nerdscope, which was suggested by my friend and buddy, brother in music, Wayne Ridnour, who's always in here, and he helps moderate the Daily Nerdler. He suggests we build a Nerdscope, so I'm building it in 3D Studio Max. Yes, a legit copy of 3D Studio Max. Don't pirate software, please. It's not a victimless crime, or movies for that matter, or music, please.